Denver. I am here with the fantastic Dr. Charissa Lee. She is just such an inspirational woman in my life, and so I just was so excited to have you here with me today, and we can just talk about just life and fun and just good things. So I have gotten to see you be a mom and a doctor and a wife and literally take over the world. So what is your secret?
It really is about really being organized, quite honestly, but it's also about living in whatever moment you're in.
How do you like figure out what is the right place to go? What is the, you know, when do I say no? When do I say yes? When do I ask for more?
It's always a learning journey. Mm-hmm. So I say these things, and these are my mantras and the mottos that I live by, mm-hmm. and then living into them is a totally different story. And saying no is one of those difficult things. So I would say I'm getting much better. Mm-hmm. At saying no, but really being focused. And it's not just about saying no, but it's also about the why, you know, mm-hmm. and really being focused on what the priorities are.
Yeah. How about advice? I'm a young optometrist about to go off and adventure into the real world of being an OD. What advice do you have for me and other students like me that are kind of figuring out where to go next?
I would say embrace opportunity. So sometimes we have a hard time with change, or we have a difficult time embracing change. But I learned, I actually very early on in my career was really lucky enough to have opportunities come that forced me into situations where I didn't think I would really be good at doing those. And it turned out that it was really fun. So things that I thought, I'm not sure if I would like it, or I'm not sure if I would be good at it, but then I tried it and then it was really fun, it was fulfilling. And so with that, I learned that opportunities that come, you don't know what's behind them, but if you're not trying them, you're never gonna know if you end up liking it or not. Keep life interesting.
Yes.
Keep life fun.
Yeah.
And enjoy it. So, you know, I don't think that we have straight and narrow pathways. I think that there's forks all along the way. Mm-hmm. You know, the best analogy that I have heard is that life is like a jungle gym. You just have different vantage points along the way, and you're always moving, but it's not necessarily always in one direction.
Yeah.
So embrace opportunities.
We kind of have talked about defining advocacy as like coming together as one collective voice. How does that kind of like definition affect our patients and us as in our profession as practitioners?
Well, you know, patient care is really at the heart of everything that I do for the profession, everything mm-hmm. that I do in my current role, and everything that I will do in my future roles. Mm-hmm. It really is something that, you know, here at Johnson & Johnson Vision, I love the fact that we can embrace that as well. So mm-hmm. patients are really at the center of everything we do.
Yeah.
So from an advocacy standpoint, I would say that having a collective voice and having a strong voice mm-hmm. is so important because there's so many misconceptions out there. Mm-hmm. And so really to be champions for our patient in terms of eye health and safety, it's important for us to act collectively rather than to have many voices that are dissonant. So I strongly believe in that as well.
Well, thank you so much for coming and chatting. It's so good to catch up, as well as just kind of allow other people to get an insight on how awesome you are. So I thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.